What if there was a history to every Minecraft world? It doesn't sound impossible, because you spawn with nothing. So why do they spawn not only with stuff, but a whole village? When did that happen? That couldn't happen right before you spawned in the world. No, that should have happened years and years before that. Around 10,000 years before you spawned in the world, villagers were small groups which were always on the move. This was their only way of surviving, to hunt down wild animals and gather all sorts of food along the way to stay alive. It is what I have done for thousands of years. They knew they wouldn't survive by standing still, because their food was always on the move as well.
Hey, let's stay here, said a villager.
So one day, they stood still.
Well, that sounds like a stupid idea.
And to much surprise, that decision didn't cause them to die. Quite frankly, the opposite happened. They finally figured out they could use grass as food. And because grass has seeds, they could just stay in one place and replant it to make even better, more tasty grass. So that's what they did. They built their first houses out of branches and dirt alongside rivers. Because it's flat, there's enough water, and the dirt is perfect for growing food. This was the beginning of villages as we all know them today. Now, with a permanent place to stay, they could make more people. And more people meant more food and more houses to put them in. But at some point, that wasn't enough. There needed to be improvements for them to grow even more. So they made better houses with a clay mixture for the walls, supported by wood, and the wheat parts they didn't eat as roofs. The village was still relatively small. There were no roads, but the grass slowly changed color into pathways, which was just dead grass from the villagers walking over it all the time. There were no walls, because villagers are very, very peaceful and didn't start wars with each other. So there was no need to waste materials on that. And all the farms still needed to be built directly next to rivers, which couldn't be huge. That would mean further away from the village, and more walking means more danger. At that time, wheat was the main source of food. There were cows in the area, but wild. They didn't want to be close to the villagers. Most probably because when another species comes towards you, it probably wants to eat you. This formula can be turned around, which is what villagers were about to test out.
Hey, want to come join us?
No.
What if we give you wheat?
Okay, sure. At this point, villagers had more food, growth in population, better houses, and animal friends. They only had to build fences around them, so they wouldn't run away after they realized
they are the food.
Everything seemed to be normal, until something strange happened. The villagers saw something appear out of nowhere. They didn't know what it was. But before they could reach it, it was already gone, leaving only a half-broken, flying tree behind. No one could explain what just happened, so they tried to make sense of it by calling it work of the gods. With the fear of making the gods at some point angry, they began making temples for them to offer their goods for a hopeful future. The village grew even bigger and bigger, with more farms providing more food. This way, less people had to farm to feed everyone. This small group could do other work and had the time to come up with new inventions, like this oven used for hardening clay pots, making it easier to transport water from the river to the village. Also, after graining down their wheat and baking it, bread was created instead of the mushy wheat soup they always had. Horses were tamed, mines were made, and the wheel was invented.
Okay, maybe not the wheel. That doesn't make very much sense in this game.
As quick as this all seemed to go, it was by far not the fastest growing village. For that, we need to go elsewhere. This was one of the fastest growing, most advanced civilizations in Minecraft. With the help of animals, desert civilizations created better, more efficient farming, so more people could do other things, like building temples for worshipping their gods, where they would also store valuable items to use in the afterlife. They also began writing in the form of hieroglyphic texts and images,
in stone and on their new writing method, papyrus, better known as the first form of paper, created from the sugarcanes growing across their long stretching rivers. There was even honey made. With all these people and resources, trading became very common, with the use of wheat as payments and markets across the village. But that was all about to change with the finding of one precious metal, which was hidden deep down in their mines: gold. Gold became the new currency between villagers, boosting trade to a whole new level. Traders made their first appearance using llamas for carrying goods over long distances between different villages, making connections and creating the first societies. Back to where we began, glass has just been made out of sand to create bottles for better storage of water, honey, and later on, potions. It didn't have that much of an impact though, because villagers still lived in the Stone Age, using stone tools, not able to do the things they're capable of doing today. But that was about to change. After more mining, iron had just been found, which led the world into the Iron Age. Finally, there were some decent tools for making stone houses and bigger projects. The clay huts slowly disappeared and were turned into houses made out of cobblestone, hardened clay, glass windows, and wooden planks. Something green and shiny had just been found in the mines. It was so beautiful. Villagers would even prefer it over gold to use it as their new currency. It was so popular that every villager started mining some emeralds for themselves or trading it with their own goods. The reason for this insane demand is unknown, but it could have something to do with the eye color of villagers, which is green as well. This made emeralds the most rare ore in Minecraft, only to be found in mountain biomes today, because villagers never went there. Oh, and they also found some blue stuff, but they didn't care that much about lapis lazuli. Meanwhile, a lot of villagers were farmers. A couple were building houses or mining, but all of these new inventions came also with a lot of new jobs. Libraries were built for education. Potion makers were trying out all sorts of recipes, and the blast furnace created blacksmiths. They even learned to build farms away from the river by creating canals besides the farmlands, making it possible to make new villages away from rivers and making it look more like the villages of today. Everything went well because there was no war, there were no thieves or crimes due to the peaceful nature of villagers. They all lived together in harmony, creating bigger communities and even bigger villages. They didn't know that one mistake would change that forever. 115 years before you spawned in the world, potion makers experimented with some new ingredients, not knowing what it would do to them. For safety, it was tested on one villager to see if it would do something useful and if there were any side effects. But it did nothing. No effects were observed physically or mentally by the potion makers and by asking the villager. There was no point of testing anymore, because they thought that nothing could go wrong. So the experiment got cancelled. But oh, how wrong they were with that. 1 year later, things began to change. Emeralds were missing. It didn't make much sense, because this never really happened before. Not all, but there were too many missing. It couldn't be a coincidence. It couldn't be the dumb fault of everyone just losing them in their houses. Was it the work of the gods? Was there anything they did wrong to deserve this? Was their greed of emeralds grown so much that they were taken from them? They didn't know, but at this point, everyone was on alert mode. Weeks went by without any traces or signs of what happened. It was still a mystery until it happened again. More emeralds were missing, but this time they saw what happened. It turned out that a group of villagers began stealing, something nobody had ever done before. Did their greed for emeralds grow so much that they would even steal for it? The villagers didn't have a single clue on what to do next, only taking the emeralds back with a warning, locking them up, or even banning them from the village. They chose to only take back the emeralds and gave them a warning, in the hope they would learn from their mistakes. But it got worse. More villagers began stealing. It looked like this behavior was spreading across the communities like a disease. And stealing was just the beginning. Things became more and more violent. They began creating groups and started fighting. One of the villagers became so harmful, the only option would be to lock him up. And to much surprise, it was the original villager from the cancelled experiment. It turned out it wasn't the greed that had grown. It was the evil inside them that grew over time, which made them steal and now turned to violence. This villager was exposed the longest to the disease, which made him the most dangerous. It wasn't sure if the others would become this violent, because they weren't exposed directly to the potion more than a year ago. Only time could tell. 4 years after the experiment, all chaos broke loose. Half of the villager population became involved in crimes, and signs of the disease became more clear. Their skins became paler and their voices began to change. At this point, the infected villagers couldn't be under control anymore. They were not villagers anymore. And because they were so evil, they were called illagers, short for evil villagers. They were seen as outcasts who burned down the villages they lived in. There was no way they could turn back to normal. So there was only one option left: banning them from the villages. Although not easy, they succeeded to do it by only banning small groups at a time, causing them not to stand together to fight back, and leaving them separate and scattered across the world after they were banned. After a year of banning, peace finally returned. Villages were safe again, but the fear of them coming back one day was still there. 100 years before World Generation, illagers across the world came together with 10 more years of growing evil inside of them. It came to a point where they wanted to do the extreme. The hate towards the peaceful villagers who banned them became so much they wanted to start a war. Crossbows and axes were equipped, outposts were made, and the war had started. Villagers were overrun, not prepared for anything like this. Big parts of villages burned down, the population decreased, and trade routes were plundered. All chaos broke loose once again, but this time at the cost of all villagers. Villagers didn't have anything to fight back with. They weren't even a fan of fighting, so miners and potion makers came together to use their iron and potions to create iron golems as protectors of the village. This move was so effective that the illagers couldn't win anymore without iron golems for themselves. They had to back off and come up with something. And that something became the Revenger, also known as the Man-Eater. With the head of a person and the body of an animal, this beast would be the weapon used to destroy all the villages. It was the biggest battle ever seen in Minecraft, both sides losing countless lives, but the villagers kept making iron golems with the endless supply of iron out of their mines. This way, illagers could be defeated forever. The illagers, however, knew this and wouldn't let that happen. They tried a desperate counterattack to destroy the mines, and they did. There was no access to the mines anymore. But this counterattack was almost fatal for the illagers, and they once again had to back off. They couldn't win. After years and years of fighting, the battles were finally over. But the war would never be. Villagers were smaller, with only a handful of villagers left who still had to deal with raiders stopping by. Some of the iron golems got captured. The traders, which connected all the villagers across the world with trade routes, became too scared, turning into wandering traders, avoiding any contact with the evil villagers, making every village isolated. But after all this, you spawned in the world. beginning to gather wood, making tools, and explore, discovering this isolated village with scared villagers. But you weren't the only one coming through from another place into this world. The moment you spawned in the world, all different kinds of mobs came with you. Zombies, creepers, skeletons, endermans from the end, and huge spiders, most likely from Australia, all scattered across the world. But this story isn't over yet. This was only the history from before you spawned into the world of Minecraft. Villagers still have a lot planned for the future.